Well, Hamas militants have launched a rocket assault on Jerusalem, the first time the city has been targeted in decades, and the first such attack from Gaza. Well, Raheem Kassam from the UK think tank the Henry Jackson Society is on a fact-finding mission to Jerusalem. He joins us now. Good evening to you. Thanks for being with us. Can you give us a sense of the mood in Jerusalem now? I mean, are people fearful now that the war on the southern border seems to be getting closer to them?
Yes, certainly very fearful. I mean, obviously going into Friday evening, which is the you know, the Jewish holy day, Shabbat has come in now, so the streets are quite clear anyway. But the siren sounded in Jerusalem a few hours ago, and it caused quite a lot of panic. People aren't used to hearing that in Jerusalem, haven't been used to hearing that for a while. Jerusalem's had its history of having a lot of suicide bombings there. But when sort of the rockets were hitting Tel Aviv, a lot of the experts were saying, well, you know, not to worry about Jerusalem because Hamas can't and won't target there. Well, now we're learning something entirely different. They will. They will indiscriminately fire at Israel's capital. Also, the worry is that they might even hit Arab neighbourhoods, Palestinian neighbourhoods. They don't seem to worry about that.
Sure. It's interesting, isn't it? I mean, given the fact that Jerusalem is now a target or seems to be a target, is the government still carrying the public with it in this conflict? Or is there a sense that perhaps the Israelis shouldn't have gone after the security man from Hamas that they attacked a few days ago?
Well, I think that's probably based on the premise that the attack on the Hamas military leader was the start of this. It certainly wasn't the start of this. Hamas has over the last few weeks been firing hundreds of rockets into Israel, and the situation escalated to a point where Israel knew it had to take action. It then decided to launch the operation Pillar of Defense, or Pillar of Cloud, military operation to target Hamas facilities. One of the Hamas individuals it took out was the military commander, as mentioned. And as such, I think the public in Israel, the reaction has been that actually, yes, this was the right thing to do. Something must be done when civilians are being indiscriminately targeted. And although it's led to a further escalation, no thanks in part due to Egypt's involvement in this, as was mentioned by your correspondent earlier, that the public really do realise that the Israeli Defence Forces, the Israeli government, are genuinely trying to root out terrorist targets in Gaza. They've hit over 300 sites, I believe, over the past few days, and there are many more instalments to be going after.
You make a good point. I mean, some people have suggested that perhaps, you know, the Israelis did begin this because of the assault on Hamas. But in fact, as you say, the rocket fire from the Gaza side has been ratcheted up over the last few weeks or so. And the suggestion perhaps is that it's Hamas who are actually trying to test the resolve of Egypt, the new Egypt now, to find out where they would lie in any future conflict, rather than the other way around, rather than the Israelis trying to test the resolve of Mohamed Morsi.
Well, that's absolutely true. I think any rational person could see that now, because, you know, the day after a major assault was launched to take out these terrorist targets, the Egyptian prime minister flies into Gaza. Now, effectively, what that does is removes Israel's power, unless they want to provoke a war with Egypt, from actually targeting Gaza. And it's been more silent than it would have been otherwise if the Egyptian prime minister wasn't there. So that's true. And I think what's also important to realize is that it's not just the hundreds of rockets that have been hitting Israel in the past few days, but the thousands over the last year or so. And over the last decade, you're looking at around about 13,000 rockets that have come over from there. So, you know, those are very serious numbers we're talking about. And I guess Israel can't be expected just to sit there and take it.
Sure. OK, Raheem Kassam, thanks for joining us. Thank you, live from Jerusalem. Thanks.